You asked me to come, I'm here. I run a very successful aeronautics engineering company. I'm richer than God. Do I appear to have lost contact with reality?
Well, what about post-abduction syndrome?
I admit to bouts with it. Frankly, it's one of my main motivators. When we meet the visitors face to face, they will explain so many things to us.
Great. Do you, know this guy?
Colonel Howard, of course.
So it's true that you offered him a position with the STC?
Yes.
As a method of bringing credibility to your organization?
Yes, but you have to understand, it was Colonel Howard who came to us.
Why?
He wanted to pilot our suborbital flights.
Till your spaceships were ready.
Laugh if you must, but Cal didn't think we were crazy. He'd seen something himself up there, you know, and he's hardly the first. Quite a few astronauts and military pilots have reported seeing evidence of the visitors.
Colonel Howard told you this?
Yes, he did. So trust me. I would have been proud to have been the one that sent Cal Howard back into space.
I swear it will not happen again.
You always say that.
Without you?
Without my girls? I'm nothing. Come home to me. I'll see you then.
Did you make it with him?
Roger, not in front of the girls.
Can you make it with him?
No, he didn't.
Good. That's good.
You can't be serious.
Do we look like comedians?
Why would I go after Alan when you guys would come straight to me?
If you were as smart as you think you are, you'd still be ripping off investors.
There's other people after Alan, okay? People capable of things that I'm not.
You signed up Richard Conlon. The guy's connected.
I had to. We needed cash.
We have to pay him.
With what money, Garrett?
It's all gone.
2 days later, we were raided by the feds. All of our assets were frozen. Conlon got a fraction of his money. He still wants the rest.
Feels a little convenient, you pushing this off on the mob.
I've been getting threats from his people on a daily basis. I know Alan has, too.
We'll look into it. But as far as I'm concerned, you're not off the hook.
You shouldn't have all the burden of paying the bills.
Trying to find a job, Helen.
You're not a surgeon. You sell cars. How hard can it be?
I don't sell cars. I manage a dealership.
I did this for us. I don't care what happens to me. I just wanted her out of our lives. Look, maybe I should have a lawyer.
You don't need a lawyer, Paul. We know you did this. You want to help yourself? Help me understand why.
If you and me, would you get a lawyer?
We're doing fine.
I think that's it. If I could just have your home phone number in case I have any other questions.
It's the same as my sister's. We live together.
Really? Just out of curiosity, what would you say if one of my other questions was, can I take you out to dinner?
Woo, you caught me off guard with that one.
That's my job.
Carolyn arranged for us to have a private tour of the Capitol and the old executive office building. And she seemed to know everybody. We were so proud of her. When she took us to the airport, I remember saying goodbye. She looked so sad. And she said it was because we were leaving. But now I know it was because she was alone. I gotta go. I should go.
Judge Rifkin?
Yes.
You don't want to put that animal back on the street so he could kill my sister?
Easy, Mike.
Easy? You want me to go easy? Why? Why? So this man can ease his conscience? So he could get off the hook? Is that it? Well, the hell with that. I would like to see him suffer. I would like to see you suffer the way that girl suffered. You bleeding heart bastard.
Stop it.